I wanted to end it all. I really did want to end it all. I just thought, well, I'm paralysed. It can't get any worse than this. Just because I can't walk, just because I've got respiratory failure, just because I can't do things physically for myself, it doesn't mean that I haven't got a life. Well, I've been GCSE, yes, I've been 16. I just started falling over, basically thin air. I'd fall and I'd look back thinking, well, what have I just fell over? And it literally was nothing. And that my spine at 18 looked like a 60-year-old spine. I'd gone to get up and couldn't move from the waist down. Couldn't move my legs at all. My mum thought I was joking originally. And I was like, I just cannot move. Been on and off antidepressants that many times for 10 years. I mean, I've only just come off them again for what I'm hoping to be the final time. I always say I might not be able to walk, I might not be able to do the things that a typical 28-year-old can do, but I can still do them in my own way. It's like makeup, I might never be a makeup artist, but I know that even with normal brushes, I use normal makeup brushes, and even though my hands don't like to work how everybody else's does, I've got my own way of being able to hold them. Sometimes I must admit, my teeth come in handy for opening the brushes. The mascaras or the lip glosses, or I even use my mouth to turn them around. I can still do it, and I think it does need to be talked about, both spinal cord injury and mental health.